Today, we're diving into a topic that's pretty common in the no-code community. Why Bubble is becoming the go-to platform for web app development, and is it right for my project? If you've been following the no-code movement, you've probably heard of Bubble, but what you might not know is just how powerful and versatile this tool really is. By the end of this video, you'll understand everything you need to know to decide if Bubble is right for you. What I'm about to share will save you countless hours of research and potentially thousands of dollars in development costs. Before we jump in, if you're looking to level up your no-code and AI skills, head over to nocode.mba. We've got courses on everything from Webflow to Bubble, and even how to build AI-powered apps. But let's dive into this video. First up, let's talk about Bubble's visual development environment. The platform provides a graphical drag-and-drop interface for designing and building web applications without writing code. It uses a what-you-see-is-what-you-get approach, allowing users to visually design their app's interface and immediately see what it will look like in the editor. Users can access a wide range of pre-built elements such as buttons, input fields, containers, etc. to construct their app's user interface. And then the environment includes features for creating responsive design layouts that adapt to different screen sizes and devices. So you can take your editor and see what it looks like on different screen sizes to make sure that you have a mobile-friendly app. You can also control all the colors, fonts, sizes, and other design properties and save those as styles that you can reuse throughout your app. On the database side, Bubble allows you to create and manage your app's data structure without writing database queries, so it's all done from the back end by just creating your database tables. It has a workflow editor to create complex logic that you can see a step-by-step out of how it is written out, so you can build logic without writing code. There's a real-time preview, so you can make changes in the editor and then go to your preview app and immediately test it out and see what it looks like. And then there's also collaboration features, so you can have teams working together in a Bubble and working on the same project. One of my favorite parts of Bubble is the plugin ecosystem. So users can extend the functionality of their apps by integrating various plugins directly from the visual environment. The plugins are really great. They allow you to add tons of functionality that you would otherwise just wouldn't have built into the platform or would have to write custom code for. A lot of the plugins are free. Some of the more powerful plugins you do have to pay, but none of them are too expensive. Typically, it's a low monthly fee, or the most expensive that I've seen is like an $80 or $100 one-time fee for the plugin. Next, it has API integration built into its platform. So you can use Bubble's API connector to connect to just about any API out there. This is something we cover a lot in No-Code MBA's Building Apps with AI course and Bubble course, where you learn how to connect to AI APIs such as Stable Diffusion, OpenAI, and things like that. So Bubble is really great for building AI apps because it has that API connector. Okay, so now let's talk a little bit more about Bubble's database and backend. So in Bubble, you create data types, which are equivalent to tables in a traditional database. Each data type represents a distinct entity in your application, such as users or products or orders. And then inside of those data types, you have fields to store more specific pieces of information. Fields can be various types, including text, number, yes, no, so a Boolean, a date, file, and other custom data types. And you can also create relationships between different data types, which is similar to foreign keys in traditional databases, if you're familiar with that. It also has automatic key management. So Bubble automatically handles primary and foreign keys behind the scenes, simplifying the process of creating those relationships between data types. So again, if you're familiar with traditional databases, that terminology will make sense to you. If not, just know that Bubble is taking care of all of this behind the scenes. Bubble also has built-in user types. So by default, when you create your app, it's going to come with a predefined user type, which handles user authentication and basic user information like email. Changes made to the database structure are immediately reflected in your app's design and workflow. And even if you change the name of a database table, it will automatically get updated in all of your workflows as well. So it makes it really easy to manage. Bubble also provides built-in tools for searching and filtering data within your application. So if you want to display, you know, filtered results from your application, such as, you know, a list of things that belong to a specific user, all of that is done really easily within Bubble and the repeating groups within Bubble. There's also something called privacy rules in Bubble, which allows you to control access to your data based on user roles or other conditions. This is something that's really important to set up correctly and something we cover inside of No-Code MBA, where if you don't set up your privacy rules correctly, then anyone can, with a little bit of coding knowledge, see data in your database that should be private. The last thing I'm going to talk a little bit more about is Bubble's workflow editor. The workflow editor is where you define the logic of your app. Bubble allows you to trigger workflows by a variety of things, such as button clicks on your page, page loads, or data changes. So this is something that you can set up in your workflow editor and something that we cover inside of No-Code MBA as well. So an example of that is if someone, you know, presses the sign up button, that would trigger the sign up workflow, which would then sign the user up. A workflow is made up of a set of actions. So in that sign up workflow, for example, one action would be signing the user up, and then another action could be going to the dashboard. So there would be two actions in that one workflow, for example. Something else that's really helpful to know about Bubble is that it has front end workflows and back end workflows. So front end workflows are workflows that are run on the page. And then backend workflows are something that you can schedule from the page and then run in the future. You can schedule them to run in the future. You can schedule them to run on a list of things. There's a lot of more details that you can get into with backend workflows. It gets a little bit complicated. But if you're new to Bubble, know that it allows you to do both of these types of workflows. Now let's talk about integrations and APIs. This is my personal favorite part of Bubble and one of the reasons that I keep coming back to it. Is that you can easily integrate with popular services like Stripe, OpenAI, Anthropic, Stable Diffusion, and other services like that. This means that if there's a service out there that you want to integrate with, chances are you can do it with Bubble. Now I want to address a common concern with no-code platforms: scalability and performance. Bubble can handle small to medium-sized projects and can scale to support thousands of concurrent users. Some apps on Bubble have successfully handled over 150,000 users in a day. To scale effectively, you do need to follow best practices like minimizing data modifications, optimizing your workflows, and making sure that you've architected your app correctly. These are all things that we cover inside of No-Code MBA to make sure that you're building your app correctly. Now, a couple limitations to be aware of with Bubble. One is that it doesn't allow access to or customization to the app's source code. So this is something that can affect long-term scalability or your strategic flexibility if you want to have that source code to potentially go off Bubble in the future. That's not something that Bubble currently allows. And then the hosting costs for Bubble, so paying Bubble to run your app, are significantly more expensive than if you were to run, you know, those own hosting costs yourself with something like AWS. But what you're paying for with Bubble is all of the things that I've talked about before, and how it handles all of those things for you. So you can just focus on building your app and Bubble will take care of all of the rest. Now on to community. Bubble has a thriving community of developers and entrepreneurs. This means that if you ever get stuck, there's a good chance someone has already encountered and solved your problem. There are so many times when I've been building in Bubble, wanted to build a feature or I'm stuck, I search it online and there's a forum post about it, where someone has already solved my problem. So it's something that I find really helpful with Bubble. And when you're selecting which no-code tool to use, using a tool that has a really active and large community is really, really helpful. One of the things that I love most about Bubble is their commitment to continuous improvement. Just as one example, Bubble just released a new AI page builder feature, which aims to help users create web pages more quickly and easily. You can describe the type of page that you want, and then Bubble's AI will generate a customized page design based on that description. I've used it and it works pretty good, especially for things like dashboards or landing pages if you want to quickly spin something up. While Bubble is incredibly powerful, it does have a steeper learning curve. It's not something that you're going to master overnight, but the investment in learning is well worth it given the platform's capabilities. If you want to dive deeper into using Bubble to build your web applications, check out our courses at nocode.mba. We cover everything from the basics of building in Bubble to advanced techniques for building complex applications. Thanks again for watching. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get all of our future content here for free. And I'll see you in the next video.